if you're going for a VAT number that's not in your country, also when it's in your country actually. In other words, if you start a business and they ask you about expected revenue, then you should lowball this number, because I made the mistake and I highballed it, and that's the reason why I got wrecked basically. So stupid. Oh my god, your expected revenue, lowball it. This might save you a bit of trouble.
Initiating. Welcome back to my daily grind. Create yourself is what you'll find me doing every day and every night. No time to lose, one day, one step in the right direction. I'm Chris and I'm only here to show you if I can do it, you can do it too.
Welcome back to the vlog. It is Monday, another day, another chance to push hard. And the topic for this vlog is my German VAT fiasco. So let's get it. By the way, all the storytime vlogs right here. Watch them all. But before we get started, of course, out to all my subscribers. Thank you for making my life special and worth living to the max. So let me try to get back with a sweet, sweet video. So as you know, well, this is one of these Amazon vlogs, Amazon FBA diary vlogs. The last vlog, check it out right here. Yeah, so many problems. A few months back in September, I think. Yeah. I got my German VAT number. Oh yeah, and by the way, the lesson from this, I will put this right at the start of this video. If you're going for a VAT number that's not in your country, also when it's in your country actually, in other words, if you start a business and they ask you about expected revenue, then you should lowball this number, this value, extremely lowball it, because I made the mistake and I highballed it, and that's the reason why I got wrecked basically. So stupid. Oh my god, your expected revenue, lowball it. Really? Do a freaking lowball on this. This might save you a bit of trouble. So let me explain. So in September, I filled out the request and I also had to fill out a projected revenue, like estimated revenue. And I filled out 5,000 bucks for the rest of the year. So for 4 months. And then in the next year, in 2020, 25,000 bucks. Like, that was not lowballed whatsoever. I should have said maybe like 500 euros and then maybe like 2000 or something like that. And now let me get to the problem, because you're required to do a monthly preliminary VAT return. You have to state your estimated VAT every month at the end of every month actually, and you have 10 days time after the month has passed. So to the 10th of the next month, you have time to submit this estimation. And I did not do this. That's why they took the 5,000 euros that I wrote, and then they split this up into the month, into the four remaining months of this year. And then they estimated a VAT that I have to pay for each month, plus a penalty payment because I was late, because I didn't do it. So all in all, I mean, it's not too bad. You know, I try to keep it 100 with my savings, but all in all, it cost me over 1,000 bucks just because I was lazy and stupid. To be specific, in September of 2019, the penalty payment was 20 bucks and the projected VAT was 237 bucks and 50 cents. In reality, it was basically zero, maybe like a few bucks. I think I sold like 3 products on Amazon. Then pretty much the exact same stuff on October and the same stuff on November. And on December, it was a bit more, already 25 bucks penalty payment and 266 bucks. Of estimated VAT. Now I'm currently in the process of this online thingy. In Austria we have this online finance, thingy, and in Germany too, it's called Elster, and I will get to that in the next vlog. How hard is it to, do this preliminary VAT thingy on Elster? You can check it out right here. This will be the, well, I hope I will get to this very soon, because as of now it is already March 2020, and this means there will be 2 more months, January and February, of penalty payments and way too high VAT estimates that I need to pay. I think this awaits me in around 1 month, so I basically have to do my annual financial statement, then I will get back the VAT, hopefully. I mean, I should get it back, because when I declare this in hindsight, then I should get it all back, so this is not a problem. It could have been a problem if I, you get it. So that was another stupid story. It didn't have to be this way. As always, it's just because I'm lazy and dumb. But here we are once again. At least it's a step in the right direction that I took. I mean, yeah, it's a lesson. Don't mess with the tax authorities. Just don't do it. Okay, so this will get continued in the next vlog when I get to the Elster stuff and all of that. I'm currently waiting for the online code, for the registration codes. Well, I'm waiting for the code that I need to complete my registration on the Elster platform. Yeah. Anyway, smash that like button away. I got kind of smashed by the German tax office. Bang the bell like clap, pop, never miss stupid storytime vlogs. And check the recent news on chrisvara.com. And that's it for today. I will see you tomorrow.